You are entering the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, a collection of vintage recordings curated by your host, Tom Holmes.
This episode, Phonographic Education, a Sound Collage.
And now for a little change. I pretend that I feel myself going down in a soft chair or in a soft bed or going down.
Hello, welcome to the Archive of Electronic Music. This is Tom Holmes. What we know of as electronic music includes a broad spectrum of genres and styles and methods. Typically, electronic music involves the use of electronic instruments to create sounds that other instruments cannot make. But there is another category of sound collage, or music concrete, or electroacoustic music that can involve the reassembly of fragments of audio from other recorded sources. And for this episode, I'm going to do just that. I've gathered and remixed many audio fragments from a selection of educational and instructional records found in my archive. This is, in part, an exercise in turntablism, but it's only partially recorded in real time. I captured samples from vinyl records and then remixed them using Virtual DJ, creating several separate remixes that I then categorized into spoken word and musical tracks. I then remixed all of these to create this podcast. Some of the editing is planned and purposeful, but much of it is left to chance, but can be surprisingly poignant nonetheless. Most of the recordings are from the 1950s, 60s, and 70s. Like I said, I placed the recordings into two separate categories, one for music and one for educational or spoken word. The playlist included here has most of these albums listed, but does not attempt to identify the tracks I used because, honestly, I was mostly focused on capturing momentary sound elements rather than entire tracks. With the exception of a few cases, none of the spoken word records contained music. That means that when you hear music and text at the same time, well, that relationship between the two was somewhat randomly chosen. I hope you enjoy the collage and mishmash of various unrelated sounds thrown together in some kind of half-meaningful arrangement. So generally, in terms of the archive itself, I do collect some spoken word records and things, especially when they have sound effects that are electronic. But in collecting those, it's hard to resist the many numerous other records that one sees when one is going through the record crates at the record store. And this is, in a way, my way of making use of those and justifying that investment in these records. So I hope you enjoy this collage that I'm calling Phonographic Education. And let's get started. This is Tom Holmes, and you are listening to the Archive of Electronic Music.
I would like to see the hands of any Episcopalians who are here with the Institute, not any by chance, who are here from town.
Vi føler dem friskere og mer opplagt.
The use of respiratory stimulants in anesthesiology is an extremely important question. In cases of circulatory and respiratory failure, physicians must utilize whatever means are at their disposal to reverse this medical emergency.
Så tar de igjen øvelsen tilbake som tidligere ved å strekke på armene, puste dypt og åpne øynene.
But in the past, the use of respiratory stimulants had frequently been associated with side effects.
Så kan de gjerne ligge en stund og nyte denne behagelige tilstand og la suggesjonene enda få virke litt.
Sputnik 1 in orbit.
Denne tilstand av ro og velbehag.
Comme toutes les grandes journées de l'histoire de France, mai 68 se sera joué avec la rigueur des grands classiques. Trois actes, trois personnages. Premier acte, les barricades au quartier latin.
That's what thinking is like. Your mind is unfathomable.
Birmingham, September 11th. Mr. Peter Blake, 17 Lexington Avenue, Decatur, Alabama.
The ability Dear to Mr. compromise Blake, develops as a...
You have given us your tire business for the past 2 years.
Child grows up. A little baby has no scruples. He tries to get what he wants in any way he can.
And we want you to know that we fully appreciate your continued patronage.
As he grows up, he learns that he mustn't hurt, steal, lie, or be impolite. He also learns the penalties. These penalties imposed not only by society, but also by his own
New York, September 19th, Mr. James Hilton, 246 Fulton Street.
When he gets angry, he must control his temper. When he is frightened, he must hide his fear because it seems shameful.
West Orange, New Jersey. Dear Mr. Hilton, my client, Herman Glazer.
But the vital, demanding human nature still insists on some kind of a voice.
Has left it's with me certain papers constituting work which he performed for you at your special request.
Its real voice would sound offensive and even threatening. As a compromise, the channel of implicit communication is used.
He has advised me that there is a balance of $140 due for his work. And I have been instructed to turn over these papers to you upon payment of this amount.
Hello, weather. This is Paul Blackman calling. I'm out here at Santa Monica, and I'm planning a trip up to San Francisco this morning. May I have weather up through the San Joaquin Valley and also up through the coast, please?
Yes, I'll read you the latest sequence reports along either route. Bakersfield is reporting 2,200 scattered, 2,500 overcast, 12 miles with a light rain shower.
Supplementing our telephone conversation of yesterday.
Fresno is 2,500 overcast, visibility 15 miles. Stockton reporting 800 scattered, 1,500 overcast, 9 miles with a light rain shower.
I discussed the matter with Mr. Glazer, and he advised me to accept $120 in full payment of his claim against you.
Some of your coastal points: Santa Barbara, 3,500 overcast, visibility 12 miles, light rain shower. Santa Maria, 1,400 scattered, 4,000 overcast, visibility 8 miles.
New York, December 20th, Mrs. Nieves Ginori, 739 Commonwealth Avenue, Boston, Massachusetts. Dear Mrs. Ginori, thank you for your inquiry about conversaphone courses.
The ability to compromise develops as a child grows up.
So that I may immediately display the effectiveness, efficiency, and result-producing power of our organization.
A little baby has no scruples. He tries to get what he wants in any way he can. Concentration and listening. Of all the things we have to do in this world, thinking is the hardest. It seems so much easier not to think. To let our minds drift at will, staying on the surface, looking at the sky, never really getting down to the depths of our intelligence. Skin diving in the sea. Staying near the surface is very reassuring. We know the air is there. But when we begin to go down deeper and deeper, the terrain becomes more and more fascinating. We begin to see and observe things we never knew existed, to discover entire new worlds, perhaps unknown to anyone else. That's what thinking is like. Your mind is unfathomable. The deeper you go, the deeper you can go. Instead of getting darker, it becomes lighter. But how can we achieve that depth of thought? How can we open our minds wider and deeper at the same time? In the haphazard, topsy-turvy, upside-down and sideways existence we call life, how can we find time enough or peace enough to simply think? We live in an age where society dictates that we all stay just as busy as possible. If you're not working, you should be playing. If you're not playing, you'd better get to work. For heaven's sake, don't just sit there thinking. Well, that's all well and good. But there comes a time when we all need to be able to use our minds well, when we must be able to concentrate, to judge, to evaluate. Perhaps you're working on a special project at work or in school, or you want to learn how to do something, play chess or build.
Visual Concepts presents your reading techniques record, side one, for extended study and skill development. You will need a pen or pencil, paper, and a book of your choice. First, a slow-to-fast count drill, beginning with a 15 count. You may preview your book while drilling. A 15 count for 3 minutes. Change your hand movement. Ready? Begin. Halfway. Next page. Halfway. Next page. Visual Concepts presents your reading techniques record. 40 seconds to respond. 40 seconds to respond. Read a new section of 8 pages if you used random selection. These pages will be read at 20 seconds each. If you desire to quicken the pace, go to the next page at the halfway point. 20 seconds per page. Halfway. Enter data. Stop reading. Compute words per minute and enter data in your daily practice log. Write a good recall to check your retention.
In the choir of the ocean.
So far, bowlers, we have developed, step by step, the three essentials of good bowling form. We've practiced stance, footwork, and developed the pendulum arm swing.
Secret of good study habits is the acquired ability to focus all your mental awareness on one job and to hold it there until the job is done, plus the ability to retain, recall, and put to use what you have learned whenever you need it. This is a training record. To focus all your mental awareness on one job. After you have repeated side one of this record several times a day until you have mastered the secret of relaxation and concentration, you are now ready to use side two on study techniques. To get the best results from this practical method of study, Two things are absolutely necessary.
The secret
of good study habits is the acquired ability to focus all your mental awareness on one job. First, you will want, with a strong determination, to learn this secret of study and to hold it there until the job is done, plus the ability to retain, recall, and put to use what you have learned whenever you need it. The secret of good study habits is the acquired ability to focus all your mental awareness on one job. This is a training record, and to hold it there until the job is done. After you have repeated side one of this record several times a day until you have mastered the secret of relaxation and concentration, you are now ready to use side two on study techniques.
You're gonna have a mask? No, we don't. Listen, here's what we want to do. We want to get the guy buried. We don't care what cemetery. He's got no relatives. He's only got enough insurance to get him buried. There's nothing in it for me.
Are you sure that he's got the insurance?
He's got it all right, but that's all right. We'll bury the guy anyway. I mean, he's a member of the family, so. You know what I'm interested in? What does it cost to get the guy buried?
This telephone conversation actually happened. It is just as real as the other side of this record is unreal.
Is this the funeral director?
That's right.
I have to find out about arranging a funeral. My uncle came in from California a few days ago, and he had a heart attack and died. And we got to arrange a funeral for him.
Okay, let's put it this way. I mean, you probably inquired with other funerals.
No, I haven't yet. I was thinking that I'd call a few places and see what it would cost.
Well, how'd you get my
name? I looked it up in the telephone book, to be frank with you. And you're one of the first things that I've ever seen in my life. You're Italian.
Well, we're the oldest firm.
You're the oldest firm?
Yeah, we are.
Is it? Can we take them right down there without any, you know...
No.
No, huh?
I mean, there are certain things in laws that will not permit this thing, you see?
Now, let me see if I got it straight. The hearse and two limousines, right?
Right.
We've
right.
got to,
what
about the stone? We have to arrange
for
the stone?
Grave, right? Well, yeah, that's right.
$90 to open it. How much does it cost to close it? How do you arrange for these damn things?
Well, up here, there's a man that's the superintendent of the cemetery. He's an Italian man.
Yeah?
Well, that's $90 for the opening and closing, Rocky. See, what they call a grave is a grave. And, of course, to open up that grave is $90. That's also what they took care of after they see everything of that sort.
All right, so we got this problem straight now, I think. It's going to cost a couple $100 for the grave, and it's going to cost for you, what, $1,100?
Well, I figure...
And we'll arrange that. What did it cost for stones? $300-$400?
No, you can get a marker for $100.
$100?
Yeah.
That sounds all right.
I'm thinking a casket, the sales tax on a casket.
A sales tax? Do they charge a sales tax on caskets?
Yeah, I'm including this all in this series. See my point?
And one day exposure and you put them in the ground.
How about clothes? Clothing and so forth?
Yeah. No, you can't do it? What could you do it for?
No, not our place of business. I mean, there's other...
While you are listening to this recording, your willing attention is helping you to become more and more deeply relaxed. While you are listening to this recording, your willing attention is helping you to become more and more deeply relaxed.
Don Carter and Joe Wilmot, each one a champion bowler. Each name is familiar to bowlers as the number one. Now, we ask ourselves, What does it take to become a star bowler?
Here we are at the...
How does a bowler acquire the championship form necessary to withstand the competition at these national tournaments? Ladies and gentlemen, where today's finest bowlers have gathered to battle it out for bowling's most coveted title and trophy. In just a few seconds, we'll know. For here to tell us all about championship bowling form is that Dean of Bowlers, Joe Wilman. Joe, a member of the Brunswick Advisory Staff, we see them in action.
There's be any star bowler. That's not for us. What's good for their natural form
be any
may
star
not
bowler.
That's not for us. What's good for their natural form may not be best for you. Be
but
best
we
for
will
you.
Follow their
but
format
we...
of understanding the fundamental.
We'll follow their format of understanding the fundamentals of a good bowling style
by making them a consistent.
By making them a consistent part of your every game. If you'll open your record jacket and look at the inside right-hand page, there are instructions as to what you should have close at hand for each band. It also shows how to outline a bowling lane for practice.
If you'll open your record
follow
jacket
and look at the inside right-hand page,
there are instructions
as to what you should have. As to what you should have.
Teaching a parakeet to talk is fun, but the old method took too much time and patience. This record is specially designed to teach any healthy, normal parakeet to talk by using a scientific new method that is acknowledged to be far superior. Because a carefully trained voice, specially chosen for excellence in clarity and diction, repeats over and over the same words, the same phrase, in a manner that most parakeets are most likely to imitate. For the next few seconds, this record will be silent. It then begins your parakeet's talking lesson. In the future, start at this next groove following the short pause, and always place your parakeet near enough so that he can plainly hear the inflection and sound of every word.
Hello. Hello, baby.
While you are listening to this recording, your willing attention is helping you to become more and more deeply relaxed. So that the words and the ideas on this recording are sinking deeply into your mind.
Hello. Hello, baby.
Where they are becoming a part of your personality. Helping you to feel the way you want to feel, to do the things you want to do, and to become the kind of person you want to be.
Hello.
And especially to become a fine bowler.
Hello, baby.
Even now, you can feel a warm, comfortable sensation of deep relaxation developing in your toes.
Hello.
And your toes are becoming very deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby.
This warm, comfortable feeling of relaxation is now spreading into your feet.
Hello.
And your feet are becoming very deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby.
And now, this pleasant sensation of deep relaxation is spreading from the toes and the feet into your legs.
Hello.
And your legs are becoming very, very deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby.
Now, this sensation of relaxation is developing also in your fingers and in your hands.
Hello.
And you can feel your fingers and your hands becoming pleasantly relaxed.
Hello, baby.
and now the sensation is spreading from your fingers and your hands into your arms. And your arms are becoming very, very deeply and pleasantly relaxed.
Hello, baby.
And now this wonderful, peaceful experience of relaxation is spreading from your toes and your feet into your legs and from your fingers and your hands and your arms into your body. And your body is becoming very, very deeply relaxed.
Hello.
Settling down comfortably all over.
Hello, baby.
Very deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby.
Now you can feel your back becoming more and more deeply relaxed.
Want a kiss?
And now you can feel your abdomen becoming very deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby.
And now your chest is becoming very deeply relaxed.
Want a kiss?
And you can feel this
Hello,
wonderful sensation
baby.
Of warm,
Want a
peaceful,
kiss?
Comfortable relaxation spreading like a wave from your toes and your fingers throughout your entire body, up to your shoulders and your neck.
Hello, baby.
And your shoulders and your neck are
Want
now becoming very deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby. Want a kiss?
And now the sensation of wonderful, peaceful relaxation is spreading up into your head.
Hello, baby.
So that you have become deeply
kiss?
Relaxed. From the tip of your toes and the tip of your fingers to the top of your head. And with every breath you take, you are becoming even more deeply relaxed.
Hello, baby.
And everything you hear, everything you think, everything you feel, and everything you do. Everything.
Want a kiss?
Everything is helping you to become even more deeply relaxed. More peaceful. More quiet. And more rested. And as this recording continues, you will find that every word and every idea are going to help you to become even more deeply relaxed as they sink deeply into your personality and thereby help you to become the kind of person you want to be and the kind of bowler you want to be.
Hello, baby. Want a kiss?
Je vous invite maintenant à la détente et à la relaxation. Soyez assurés que pour vous, il n'y a aucun danger. Laissez aller simplement votre imagination et votre idée dans un vide des plus complets. Maintenant, trouvez un endroit confortable, tel votre divan, un canapé ou encore votre lit.
We can interpret Yin and Yang into the two modern concepts, that is, centrifugal force, centripetal force. And these two forces are creating every phenomena and every manifestation. Now let us see the example. Let's see the plant. That plant, small seed, that is contracting form, that is Yang. Now that seed dropped in the fall, which is the cool season, coming very cold winter.
Placez-vous en position horizontale sur le dos et fermez bien les yeux.
I was born in Japan, and I grew in the family which was very humble, economically, socially. My parents were both teachers of college and high school, and later more social educational activities. Their way of eating were very humble and grain main food. And I was brought up in the very serious busy study conditions. And I didn't know the social circumstance until I grow more late teenagers. But throughout my growing time, it was the time of war. Japan was involved with China or with other countries, and always there the feeling of social crisis or pressures, as well as economical crisis and pressures, and always high spirit, stimulated souls, always among the people.
Hold my teeth together.
No, don't clench your teeth, Danny. Just close them so that they barely touch.
Okay.
Yeah, now part your lips slightly.
Yeah.
Still hold your teeth together.
Yeah.
Part your lips slightly. No, not that big. Not like a big smile.
No.
No, just part your lips slightly. That's better. That's it. Now you have your mouth closed, your teeth together.
Je vous invite à vous étendre ou à vous installer dans une pièce aérée, fraîche, semi-obscure, où vous ne risquez pas d'être dérangé.
Your lips confortablement slightly.
Installé sur le dos, la tête supportée par une oreille mince, les bras allongés le long du corps et légèrement repliés. La paume des mains retournée vers le haut, les jambes allongées, les talons écartés de 5 à 8 pouces. Et les pieds tournés vers l'extérieur. L'utilisation d'un bon fauteuil confortable est également indiquée. Détachez tout vêtement trop serré au niveau de la taille, du thorax et du cou. Il importe avant tout de ne pas faire d'efforts volontaires pour vous détendre, mais de vous laisser simplement aller à la relaxation. Concentrez-vous le plus possible sur les bruits en essayant de ne penser à rien d'autre. Les distractions au cours d'un exercice de détente sont quand même normales et peuvent être fréquentes, surtout dans les débuts. Lorsqu'elles surviennent, ramenez sciemment et sans effort brusque Faites attention sur les coups.
That looks good, Danny. Good. Now the jaw must be relaxed, the lips parted slightly, and the tongue must be free to move around inside the mouth. The tongue feel loose in there?
Uh-huh.
Good. You see, the tongue now has to create the sound.
Stand up and stretch. Stretch higher. Then hang limp from the waist.
Your lips would normally form.
Now stretch again.
I got it.
Right. Now your teeth are together.
Now shake your arms and hands.
Not clenched.
Take your right leg. Now your left leg.
No.
Your lips are slightly
now parted.
Now
your whole body.
Yeah.
Now take a deep breath. In and out.
Good, Danny. Very good.
In and out.
Now we can go along with the
open
beginner's alphabet.
Then take another deep breath. In.
What's that?
Now don't...
And let it out with a sigh. Now to help relax
now don't open
eyes,
your mouth. Just keep your lips...
Light quick twinge, like a butterfly.
Slightly parted. Now, without
your eyes. Now open your eyes.
Without moving the
sit
lips.
Sit down in a comfortable chair. Do 10 more light blinks.
By using the tongue inside the mouth, we...
Now raise and lower your eyebrows several times.
Repeat these letters after me. You...
Then close the eyes.
You ready?
Yeah.
Good.
Now. Your eyelids have. Then do 10 light blinks. Now close your eyes and relax. Let go of the muscles in your face.
The recording will have its greatest usefulness if you do not listen to it before you try it. Your first acquaintance with it should be while following its instructions. You need no special preparations. The recording tells you everything you need to know. Merely take your record player and the record into a quiet room where you can be alone for at least an hour. Then turn on the recording and begin to follow its instructions immediately. If you're the type of person who must listen before you try it, then don't attempt to follow the instructions at all on your first hearing. You can't try just a piece of the recording and expect to obtain results. Either you should become a student from the first experience
first
with the record,
when
you still don't even know the method, or study the method in full before you try it.
It's for you to learn.
You need
to
the method from begin.
And I'm going to teach you some very simple methods. First, make yourself comfortable.
Beginning to end,
jacket,
to experience it from beginning to end.
Loosen any belts you might have. Take off your shoes.
If it's to have any meaning to you, you can't learn this method intellectually.
Make yourself really, really comfortable. If there's anything at all in your clothing that's tight, loosen it up.
It's a process of emotional learning. You must try the full recording before you can understand it. And like everything else,
you should not be aware in any way that you have clothes. Now it is possible, when you really learn to relax later, that you be able to do it standing up, sitting on an ordinary chair, lying on a couch, in any place. But
else in life, the results will be in exact proportion to the sincerity and diligence with which you approach your task.
You are listening to Phonographic Education, a sound collage on the archive of electronic music. This is Tom Holmes.
Have you ever given much thought to the world of sound, that mysterious region just beyond your eardrums? It's as close as the ring of your telephone, the rustle of wind through the trees in your backyard, or the rumble of thunder on a warm summer afternoon. In just a moment, you're going to take a journey into the most fantastic corners of that world, and there, hear things you've never heard before. Although the first sound you'll meet along the way should be familiar enough, the others are going to seem somewhat strange to your ears, and you'll most likely scratch your head a bit as you wonder what on earth they might be. On this journey, you're going to listen to four separate sounds. Each sound will be repeated three times. As you listen to each sound, attempt to picture it in your mind's eye, and then try to write a short description of it on the paper before you. As you see, this paper contains 12 rectangles or spaces. Your job, as you listen, will be to write down on those spaces the word pictures each sound calls to your mind. For example, let's say that the first sound you hear suggests, the ring of an alarm clock. Your job would be to describe the sound that way, in the first space in the top row. This row is labeled A, and that first space is labeled number one. Now, let's say that the second sound you hear might suggest the noise of right across row A, the top row. All set? Here we go then, into the mysterious world of sound. I'll bet that first sound was easy to describe, while the others really made you do some tall thinking. Now then, take your paper and fold it back along the top row so that you've covered your answers. If you folded it correctly, row B should now appear at the top of the page.
To hold it there and
the sound you have just heard was recorded on the idling engine of a diesel locomotive. This sound is one of several thousand collected and analyzed in a study program conducted by the Technical Research Department of the New York Central Railroad. The object of this program: the development of criteria and techniques for early diagnosis of conditions that lead to engine failure. The method: sonic analysis of audio data, periodically recorded on a group of 50 locomotives. Sonic analysis is the designation that we of the Central Research Laboratories have applied to the audio spectrograph technique of analyzing complex sounds. Historically, this technique was originally developed for analyzing the events and content of human speech. However, the time-indexed visual output it provides can be extremely useful in other areas of research. Figure 1 shows the equipment employed in this technique. In use, the specimen sound first is recorded on the magnetic disc to which the chart drum is attached. In subsequent analysis, the drum and disc recording revolve continuously. During each revolution, an electronic system searches the sound in one of a great number of narrow frequency bands. If sound is detected in a particular band, a horizontal trace is made across the time intervals during which the sound exists. The darkness of this trace is qualitatively related to the intensity of the sound detected. Figure 2 shows the sonic plot that results from this analysis. To aid you in interpreting this plot, we have marked the chart with visual reference data. The audio spectrum itself is the analysis of a specimen sound taken from an earlier record in the Design News Sounds of Industry series. As you listen to this sound, notice how the sonic plot reflects its nearly steady state random noise quality. In Figure 3, we revert to the classic use of this technique to demonstrate a major capability that it provides. This capability, arising from the time-indexed qualities of its frequency-intensity output data, is the means for identifying particular audio events. In this case, the events are the phonetic elements of a spoken phrase.
The New York Central Railroad.
In addition to identifying particular events, this audio spectrum also provides us with the means for detecting subtle differences in events of obvious similarity. To illustrate this, compare the sonic plots of Figure 3 and 4 as you listen to the voices that produce them.
The New York Central Railroad.
The New York Central Railroad.
In these plots, the main events, the phonetic elements, showed similarities that allowed correlation between corresponding parts of the two messages. Yet in certain areas, the sonic patterns exhibited distinct differences.
Cette période de détente, avec impression subliminale sonore, est un moment privilégié pour rompre avec le rythme de la journée. Ne vous laissez pas distraire par ce que vous auriez dû faire avant ou par ce que vous aurez à faire après. Prenez une respiration profonde en gonflant d'abord l'abdomen, puis le thorax. Expirez lentement en imaginant que vos tensions s'éliminent en même temps que l'air de vos poumons. Relâchez tous les muscles de votre corps et laissez la musique effacer doucement les tensions de la nuque, de la mâchoire, des yeux et du front. Abandonnez-vous totalement à la musique qui ainsi occupera peu à peu toute la place. Les prochaines minutes n'appartiennent qu'à vous.
Described his proposal with enough detail so that the museum could create the actual piece in Chicago while the artist remained at home. For example, C. Armajani explained,
"So, first of all, I was going to tell you that the title of it is called A Fairly Large Number, F-A-I-R-L-Y, Large Number. And it has the 1 million digit number.
Armajani explained.
Of the car and took 10 photographs of the highway.
Lights out. Everybody. This is the witching hour. It is the hour when dogs howl and evil is let loose on a sleeping world. Want to hear about it? Then turn out your lights.
The National Broadcasting Company brings you Lights Out, a revival of the eight best stories in the series which many of our listeners will remember. Willis Cooper is your author, and Albert Cruz, your director. Sit in the dark now and listen to
Lights Out.
And what will you do if I won't?
Something very unpleasant, my dear chap.
For example?
For example, it is quite possible that I will kill you.
You amaze me.
No, I assure you I'm quite serious.
It's impossible.
Not impossible at all.
May I ask just how you propose to, end my life, shall I say?
I shall cut your throat. Neatly, and as the books have it, with dispatch.
You've been reading books, then?
We're wasting time. What's the answer?
The answer is the same as it has always been.
You refuse, then?
I refuse, yes.
Very well. You force me to become a murderer.
Cut. Look, I don't want to throw you up on this first reading, but not much is coming through in here. I don't know just how to say it, but it just doesn't gel for some reason. Now, let's think about these lines. Well, let's hold it a minute.
What's the matter, George? Who is it, me or Ed?
Well, I hate to throw you up on this first reading, but, Fritz, I think it's you. Something wrong. It's the attack on the part, or maybe you're throwing those lines away without any sincerity. There's no menace in the part. You see what I mean? Well, look, let me come on out.
Hammond again, eh, Fritz?
Okay, character. Let it alone. I'm having enough trouble.
Look, he can act. Honest, George. Fella's got a card.
All right, let's can the funny stuff, Ed. We got some work to do, and I want you to just pay attention, if you don't mind.
All right.
Look, Fritz.
Yeah?
How do you feel in this thing?
I don't know. It's not right. I don't know what to do, though.
Well, you don't sound convincing. You see my point?
Yeah.
Have you got any ideas on how you might do it?
No. Oh, wait a minute. What about dialect? I could do a little German.
German? Could... Wait a minute. No. I don't think I want any German on this thing. I hear too much of that. Some Austrian? No, that's too close to German.
I don't know.
How's your French? Let's see how your French is.
Oh, it's all right.
No. Look, I don't want to make him too definite. See, he should be a kind of a combination. A lot of menace in there. Quiet, but I got to believe the guy. Make him, let's see, what's that word? I want him to...
Continental.
Yeah, that's it. Just not too much now. Just a whiff of continental, okay?
Let me try it, yeah.
All right,
yeah.
We'll try it now from the top, huh? Let's
right.
go.
Okay. And what will you do if I won't?
Something very unpleasant, my dear chap.
For example?
For example, it is quite possible that I will kill... Well, it is quite possible that I will kill... Well, it is quite possible that I will kill... Well, it is quite possible that I will kill you.
You amaze me.
I assure you, I am quite serious.
Okay, hold it.
How's it doing now? How's it sound?
Are you asking me or the director?
Well, it sounds a lot better than it did before. I think you'll work into it. Yeah, well, look, Fritz, I think that'll do it. What do you say we put it up on the mic and let's see how it sounds? Take that whole scene over.
How is it for age, George?
Oh, the age is okay. I want a little bit of age, not too much age.
All right, just a little.
About...
Thank you.
The drop shot.
Now to go from 10 to 20, let's use the letter D to represent 1. We'll begin every number or word with the letter D. Dice, using a soft C, is therefore 10. Dad, D-A-D, is 11. Dawn is 12. Dome is 13. Do you understand how this works?
The flower of life.
Dome is 13 because D represents 1 and the M
Life expresses itself through love. The stream of life is a wave on the ocean of love. Life is expressed in the waves of love. And the ocean of love flows in the waves of life. What a comfort love
now
brings.
Now to go from 10 to
heart,
20, let's use the letter
the heart
D to represent 1. We'll begin every number or word with the letter D.
Heart of love. And waves of life begin to roll on the ocean of love. Every wave of life is full with the ocean of love. Yes, such a life is worth living. Every wave of life full with the ocean of love.
And listen.
Such a life is life.
Of all the things we have to do in this world, thinking is the hardest.
Such a life is worth living.
Not to think.
And who lives such a life of all love, of bliss, of power, and of peace?
A little baby has no scruples. He tries to get what he wants in any way he can.
One wants to remain tender in the strength of love.
He mustn't hurt, steal,
the strength
lie,
of love makes one tender and firm. Makes one weak in wrong and powerful in right. Brings forgiveness in authority and grace in all fields of life.
Flight plan.
And this is
aircraft identification N2633 Golf, Cessna 310 Delta. Estimated true airspeed 190 knots.
Love.
Departing Santa Monica via Victor 25 to San Francisco.
Is the fortune of the fortunate. Abundance of love is the goal of all destiny.
Requesting 10,000. No intermediate.
Fortunate are those whose hearts are those in love, whose hearts are those in a loving heart, a heart full.
Proposing off at 1200 Pacific or 2000 Zebra.
Is fullness of the divine. Is fullness of the divine. Love is the light of divinity. Love is the light of divinity. Love is the light of divinity.
Estimating 2 hours and 15 minutes en route.
Fights. Learn to relax. Learn to relax. Stay young. Stay young. Healthy. And happy. Stay young.
I'm looking for somebody. I want you to have. Mate. I'm looking for somebody to breathe. Mate. They'll say, in my hair. Well, then don't put it on me. On me. Somebody on me. 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 I'm looking for somebody to meet.
I hope you enjoyed Phonographic Education, a sound collage on the archive of electronic music. This is Tom Holmes. Details about most of the records played in this podcast can be found in the playlist for the podcast website. Check out my blog for the Bob Moog Foundation. There's a link on my podcast website. A transcript of notes for the program are found on my blog, Noise and Notations, at tomholmes.com. If you would like to learn more about the history of electronic music, please read my book, Electronic and Experimental Music, published by Routledge in print or as an ebook. You may also want to read my book about sound art, also available from Routledge. If you enjoyed this podcast, I invite you to explore our library of past episodes. They span many genres, technologies, and artists associated with electronic music, from symphonic rock to music for meditation, and sound collages, I guess, all inspired by vintage recordings from my archive. So long for now from the Archive of Electronic Music. Happy listening!
All of the music heard on this podcast, unless otherwise indicated, is brought to you from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music, a curated collection of vintage recordings. For a complete playlist, go to theholmesarchive.podbean.com. All crackles, surface noise, and other imperfections heard in this podcast are purely intentional. All intro, outro, and other incidental music is by Tom Holmes, unless otherwise noted in the playlist. For notes about this episode, please see the blog Noise and Notations at tomholmes.com. So long from the Holmes Archive of Electronic Music.